Welcome back. It is a Woman Wednesday on Liquid Lunch, and Liquid Lunch is coming to you today as we do every single day, noon to 2 Eastern. We're in the Liquid Lunch Outpost in downtown Manhattan today, and it is a glorious day when it's Women Wednesday, but it's even better when we're joined by my good friend Consuelo Vanderbilt Costin. And she has been about the town out in Los Angeles and Hollywood, throwing some parties, attending some parties, but giving us all the great stuff that happens behind the scenes at the Oscars. And she may just be a great person to fill us in on this stuff, but she's also gonna start to join us regularly because some of my takes are all one-sided and I need somebody to keep me in line. And Consuelo has some different views than I do, and every perspective is appreciated. Consuelo, how are you today? Welcome to Liquid Lunch via Skype.
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for having me. Happy Wednesday to you.
Happy Wednesday to you. It's so much better when you're here in studio, and we're looking forward to that when you come in. And from what I understand, you're going to grace us with your presence for a whole hour and kind of co-host with me.
No.
Try to keep me in line.
Is that possible?
Well, we shall see. But you guys did some great things while you're out there. You have your company, Soho Muse, but you're also into all kinds of philanthropic efforts, of course. Tell us a little bit of what you've been doing out there while you're in Hollywood for the whole Oscar celebration.
So it has just been a crazy whirlwind, as you can imagine, just 4 days of madness. We had our event on Friday at Christopher Guy's. He was a very famous interior designer, his showroom in West Hollywood. So it was a star-studded, packed. David Arquette was there. Melora Hardin was there. It was not only just, let's say, notable actors, but just a lot of writers, entertainers. Gigi Gorgeous was one of our co-hosts, who is just this extraordinary female activist. We had a lot of fashion designers and models, and it was just a beautiful, eclectic, fantastic LA, let's say, our beautiful New York meets LA night. So it was a very, very special moment to be here.
So from what I understand, you gonna get us regular folk a little look behind the curtain at what's really happening at these posh parties. And you brought us some video as well. Let's take a look at some of the video of what was happening out in Hollywood for the Oscars.
Fantastic.
Mambo, mambo Italiano, hey, mambo, mambo Italiano, go, go, go. You mixed up Siciliano, all you Calabrese do the mambo like a crazy with a hey, mambo. Don't want a tarantella, hey, mambo, no more the mozzarella, hey, mambo. Mambo Italiano, try an enchilada with the fish baccalà. Hey, Goomba, I love how you dance a rumba. But take some of advice, Paisano, learn how to mambo. If you...
So that's all the behind-the-scenes stuff that we don't get to see, but you bring us behind the curtain. I like that one guy's dance moves there.
Right?
What do you have in store going forward? I know you can't join us again for a couple of weeks because you're heading over to London. What's happening in London?
So I'm heading to London today, actually. It's just the start of London Fashion Week. So Soho Muse, we are collaborating with Milan Breton, who is a very well-known, amazing fashion designer. He puts on these shows that are so epic and so, you know, because when you go to a fashion show, it just only really lasts like 5 to 7 minutes, and you feel like all the kind of like anticipation, you're so excited to be there, and it's like, eh. So Milan like puts on an unbelievably epic show. So we're doing that with him, and then we're actually part of the after party. And from what I hear, there's some very interesting and possibly some royal attendees.
Wow.
With that.
Then
we'll definitely keep you posted on some very exciting and, you know, behind the scene action in London.
Wow. So we may have a brush with royalty right here on Liquid Lunch through Consuelo. That could be big.
Come on now.
Yeah. So listen, I want to get your perspective on this.
Yes.
I have been getting really frustrated with these actors that we've loved for years, that we want to go support them, we want to see their art and their creativity, but then they get to the award show and then they kind of hijack the award show to stand on these different political platforms, which I don't think helps anyone. I don't know it helps them, and I don't think it helps, you know, the divide we have in our country. So I give it a fair chance. I got to cover it. I'm part of the news. And then Brad Pitt, I'm happy for him. I like him. I love almost every one of his movies. And then he gets up there, and the first thing he says is, you know, a political statement, and he's somehow or another, Brad Pitt is now an advocate for John Bolton to testify before the Senate. Couldn't they make it like a politics-free zone at the award shows?
I'm going to have to say I'm in agreement with you here. I do. I think that you really need to kind of stay in your lane, as much as this is like that one time where you really do have everyone's attention and everyone's listening, right? But it's almost when you go and you see a performer, right, you want to hear the music. You don't want to really be hearing about the political opinions. It's important, but I think that there's a time and a place for it, and then you end up losing the impact of the speech, because honestly, there's so many people that it takes to make Brad Pitt's career. Not, I mean, of course, he's brilliant and he's a celebrity. He's done amazingly well. But from the acting coaches to the stylists, there's so many teams behind these people that don't actually end up getting credited. And that's where I kind of sit and like, God, I just wish that opportunity actually could have been more about, let's really take the time to honor all the people that it took to get there, not only the film and everything else, right? I think when it becomes something just political and you're sitting there, it takes the breath out of the room, right?
Yeah, I'm with
and
you.
I'm sitting there going, come on now, really?
Don't do it. Don't do it, please. So,
and then you're cringing and you're going.
No. Yeah. I thought.
Was that, by the way, my facial reaction? Was that how you were feeling?
No. I wasn't mimicking you. I was thinking the same thing, cringeworthy. But I feel like, you know, the minute you take a political stance in this day and age, you're almost writing off 50% of your potential customer base. And, you know, I've been in the financial markets for years and all kinds of different investments and opportunities. And you never want to kill half your potential audience. And, you know, over the years, it's been said many performers and entertainers are not that great of business people. You think it's a good business decision to show your true colors and turn off maybe 50% of America?
Wow.
No, I mean, you're a great businesswoman. You know what I mean? I know you don't take political stances.
48%, it's just 50% of no, that's definitely not a good business decision. But in the same breath, I think that it's important when you do have a platform, right, to be able to speak your voice. I don't think you should stay quiet either. So I think that there's a very, very fine balance. It's choosing the right times to be stating your opinions.
Yeah,
I really feel that, right?
I understand that. And I think that's a very valid point. I happen to agree with you. I ring the bell when I agree with my guests. But yeah, I mean,
can I get my own bell too when I'm there?
Yeah, when you come in, we'll get you a bell. But when I'm with you on this, that if you have a platform and you believe in something so deeply and you don't use it, it's almost like wasting a talent. So I can understand, you know, the slippery slope that you have to walk along there. And I respect Brad Pitt and I respect, you know, a lot of these artists because, you know, I think sometimes, you know, I'm an artist and, you know, I don't always use my platform to hear all voices, but that's why you're going to join me and you're going to start helping me be a little more objective on this stuff. And even today, it was quite the enlightening experience to have some time with you. And I'm looking forward to you getting back here and letting us meet some royals, maybe electronically or videography. And hopefully in a couple weeks, you'll be here on Women Wednesday in studio with us.
Fantastic. I'm so excited. I can't wait to see you, and I will keep you posted from London about all the exciting entertainment and if we have any sightings from any royals, of course.
Fantastic. That's Consuelo Vanderbilt Cousteau from Los Angeles and Hollywood giving us the inside scoop on what's happening at the Oscars and behind the scenes at the Oscars. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back after this. We're going to give you the inside scoop from one of my favorites. Eileen Fisher is back. And Eileen is one of the top, if not the top, matchmakers and dating experts in the world, and she's going to give you some tips on what to do on Valentine's if you do have a Valentine, and what to do right now if you want to get one by Friday. Quick break, more Liquid Lunch right after this.